We've been working with the research team from Monash University, and we've been learning how to incorporate sequences of lessons with challenging tasks. Today the students are working on making shapes out of six triangles. It's part of a sequence of lessons from the unit Recognising Shape.
What is special about this way of teaching is that students are doing hard thinking. They're learning from each other and solving sophisticated mathematical problems.
The problems are open-ended, so it allows those students that if they need to be extended, they can. But everyone has the opportunity to access the learning. The enabling prompts actually do help those children progress up to what the actual problem is. This lesson actually builds on what they learnt yesterday, and I'm hoping that some of the language they explored yesterday will come through their learning today.
Quadrilaterals,
trapezium,
parallelograms,
polygons, quadrilateral.
They're all terms that they haven't heard before, so it was just exposing them, rather than just saying that this is a square, that you know it's actually a quadrilateral. How do you know it's an irregular hexagon?
Because it has six sides.
Awesome. Okay, I know you're on the right track.
This approach to teaching mathematics is different because the teachers do the mathematics prior to teaching the lesson themselves as part of a team and think about the way that the students respond to the answers.
That way I'm looking at the lesson through the eyes of my students and I can anticipate what kind of questions might come out of the lesson. Okay. There's not a lot of modelling from me. We simply look at the problem and then I pretty much send them off.
The teacher then walks around observing the students and she or he will notice the mathematics that the students are doing. She'll notice the strategies that the students are using and then start to select students that she thinks might help other students progress in the lesson.
I can share my strategies with the class so they can use my strategies and then it makes it easier and then they get on really well.
So those children that still need that little bit of assistance or guidance, it's not coming from me, it's coming from their peers, and hopefully they will then go off and use their strategies.
This phase of the lesson is when most of the mathematics is happening.
I love this way of teaching because it's actually inquiry based and the children are learning themselves without much input from me. I'm not there as the person that's modelling every example. Any child can access the learning.